What is up, my Mega Man Maker fans? I am Kirk Yeehee, and this is Mega Man Maker, where today we are playing one of your levels, and it's probably only going to be the one because last one from Apple 1, 2, 3, and kind of pissed me off. So we'll see how this goes. So we are playing Mega Man Apple 0.12 Deluge Man, level ID 517077, 20 plays, score plus 3, negative 3, created by Apple 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to say it now, even before I start it off. I'm calling you out, Twit. This is not your proof, so go ahead, play it. Mock me for being bad. I got nothing else to say. No, I'm kidding a little bit. So it looks like I am forced to Mega Buster this only. But here's the thing. These stages are supposed to be all made like you're playing through a regular Mega Man game. Now I know this. Even if there would have been powers, I wouldn't have picked them up. Because if I can't get through a stage without the Mega Buster or equivalent alone, then it's probably not thought through well, right? And that was one of the things that they wanted. They wanted information on, or they wanted feedback on things that they could improve and stuff. Apple 1, 2, 3, and did. So in order to accurately pull that off, I have to give information based on the most basic way that you may be forced to play a game like this if you don't know going into it, or if you go into it playing it like a normal game where there's no powers. So it'll be played all these stages from here on, which means I probably won't beat them. I figured I'd die here because it's not going to be an easy jump to make. But all these stages will probably be unbeatable for me and probably be not so compatible with roll. If we go by what we saw with the last stage I went through with Apple 1, 2, 3, and yeah, that power did me a lot of good. The last stage with Apple 1, 2, 3, and it was some spots, I really do question if you could have got through some spots with only roll. Because her jumping ability, her attack, while great, it's one of my things I like about her. Her attacks are quite unique. She's kind of really limited in what she can do. How come that water, or the potion or whatever it is, can only affect certain water? Or can it affect even this water if it was put into it from the eyedropper enemies? Well, we may never know. Ooh, this is a pretty precise jump for a starting, what feels like a starting stage, since there's no powers. I have to assume that's the case. Roll kind of sucks for these enemies, doesn't she? Let's charge up for this and it despawned. Of course it did. God damn it. We'll let you shoot your bubbles because I can hit you without you being opened. I kind of hate the wind. If I'm to be honest, I kind of really hate the wind. Hit me, froggies. Thank you. Safety bubble in that regard. I'm hoping I'll hit a checkpoint soon. Okay, I didn't know what they were. Thank God. Checkpoint. I'll try to play this as if it's an actual Mega Man game and I have lives. I guess I would have died there anyway. So I could have killed myself off and it would have just saved everyone half a second. So I need to desperately get these jerks killed off. Actually, no, I don't. Thank you, Sneezy. Freaking hate those guys so much. So this is going to be our first... Is this jump even makeable? No, seriously, is this jump even makeable? I had to jump off the spikes to get to the first one. Now, look at her. Useless. Useless girl. There we are. Just roll and go. There's gotta be an easier way to do that. Get away from me. I really wish the wind guys weren't there. This is a freaking... It's not that it's hard. It's just annoying. Having to constantly correct yourself. Okay. Get out of here, booger eyes. God damn it. Why can't I kill a single one of them without... Once again, this feels like one of those spots where roll wasn't really thought of fully. Okay, nope, not really sure what happened there, but You can't kill those with her while jumping. They don't take enough damage from her attack to kill them before she actually runs into them. So that is causing the first big hurdle here. Even like this, I think her charge roll does less damage than if you're just standing there. It sure, yeah, definitely does. Because I had to do two charges to take out the bottom one, and we had to do the one charge from here, so it lessens the damage even from that. Yeah, I don't know how to do this without damage boosting. It's just, to me, it's impossible. Having to fight these guys off every time is friggin' tedious, man. Okay, so I don't know, that gap there seems impossible. I feel like I'm taking my... Oh, I wish I didn't have to kill these guys off every time. It's such a slow process. Such a slow process to do this. Because you can't get them in one pass. See? You just can't. You gotta wait for the second pass. And that's 20 seconds wasted just getting them killed off. So I can try to make this jump without dying. And try to make this jump without dying. And continue... Jesus, that is barely friggin' makeable. I get it, you want your stages to be hard, but you're going to get negatives for it. That's all I'm going to say. You're going to get negatives for it. I really wish... Like, with Mega Man base or other, these enemies aren't near the issue, right? With her, they become a huge issue because you have to get up in their face, and they constantly hit you and push you around. And with that wind going, it's hard to even get your footing on a single block gap. Because there's nothing to work with. Cool. She clearly made that and then she didn't. You heard the tink for her landing. This here, I think, is probably my most hated part of it all. Because it just takes so long to kill these guys off. Just so I can attempt to make the jump. And I need all the health I can get. I have to absolutely do this. If I don't do this, and then make this jump successfully, and I'm dead. If I don't get through here with relatively full health, I have no chance in the later spot where I feel like I'm forced to take hits with Roll because of her limitations. When this is your main obstacle, it's not a good thing. The jumps should just, they don't need to be that tight. Especially, like I said, this feels like it'd be an intro stage. You have no powers. Intro stage is supposed to be an introduction to the game. It's supposed to be easy. In all honesty, you know what I'm thinking right now? I could be playing Rocket League instead of this. That's where my mind is right now. It's like, I can't even make this jump anymore. That's how annoyed and frustrated I'm getting over having to do this spot over and over and over again. I can't even make this first jump. And all I keep thinking is, I could be playing Rocket League right now. And I might. Because this is another death. That's what keeps happening. If I can make it to the first jump, that happens on the second. It's too pixel perfect. Just not working for me here. I'll vamp a little bit. Because I have a feeling I'm going to be quitting this stage pretty soon. Because this is honestly getting on my last nerve. If I can't even make it past a simple jump, and then same thing's happening. I'm literally walking most of the way off that first block before I jump. And still, most of the time, it doesn't seem to be enough. It's very frustrating because of that. Literally have to walk completely off the block before you jump, which makes no sense. Makes absolutely no sense. This area here wouldn't be half as bad either if the shrimp weren't there. They're the only real issue with this area. The slipperiness these guys provide, not a huge issue. The f***ing blowhards, on the other hand. Now to fail this jump 20 more times. Didn't feel comfortable with that one. Walk off the spot. No. Figured for sure I was as good as dead. I noticed this isn't the blipping roll either, so I can't even use my iframes to help me through some of this. See, like I said, those guys, typically not the issue, if I can do this in time. Anyway, it's the stupid shrimp, especially in a spot like this, because it appears in a horrible spot. If I stop to fight it, she stops to attack. You can't move while attacking with her. This is what you get. I'm holding left while I'm attacking. That gives the wind a chance to blow me away. So I can't even stop to attack that one if I don't get it killed off immediately. Remember, Apple123, and you were the one that wanted the criticism, so I'm doing my best to try to be objective, but if something is hard and frustrating me, I'm going to go out of my way and mention it. And this is extremely frustrating because of the way these guys are set up. Once again, it's something that feels like it's not thought through fully for roll. Especially once you get up here. Maybe if I can just skip that, she wouldn't jump. That's on this damn controller, not the game in that situation. But this controller's a piece of shit. And my other one had to die on me. Because Xbox controllers, every generation, just keeps getting worse and worse. Absolutely worse and worse. And we're back to doing that again. Fan-fucking-tastic. If nothing else, you're seeing what my real rage is like. When I'm truly pissed off, you get this from me. I'm not fun or enjoyable. I'm not happy rage, loud, angry rage. I'm annoyed. I don't feel like talking. I don't feel like playing. I'm just straight up annoyed and want this to be over. This is not how I like playing this game. I don't like being in this mood set or mindset when playing this. It's not enjoyable for me. I can't imagine it's enjoyable for you guys either. And again, my A button wouldn't jump, you controller piece of shit. I can tell you this much, if I don't quit this soon, I'm gonna have zero functioning controllers because this is pissing me off to the point that not just the game, this goddamn piece of crap controller too pissed me off to the point that I'm gonna end up destroying it. I want to hit it. I want to hurt it. I effing hate this goddamn control every f-ing time. Well, let's see if I can make this jump. Nope, still can't make this f-ing jump. Finally made it by this goddamn spot again. Just to die here, though, because that's how it always happens. I make it past that first spot, and I can't make it by here because I suck at this game. This game is absolute garbage, and I hate it. Yeah, you're getting my true rage today. You're not getting the happy fun time rage. Go ahead, keep beating my face in, you piece of shit. You can go to hell. You too. Die. Die before I do. Why won't this frog die? Holy ghost. Like, that's absolute crap. Dog's even leaving because he knows that I'm pissed off. And he wants nothing to do with it. Go back here just to kill myself so I can have a goddamn chance to make it past this screen. Yeah, I'm not a fun person when I'm actually pissed off, as you can tell. But this is what Mega Man Maker does to me. And this is why there's been many a time I've been contemplating quitting the game. Just anything if people could have gravitated toward, anything at all, it had to be this, didn't it? Why couldn't it have been Terraria or something else that I'm actually decent at? It had to be this. The one game that I'm like worse than bad at. Absolutely annoys me to no end. I think what annoys me to no end even more than that is, oh great, how was I supposed to know that was coming? But what annoys me more than that is the fact that I keep trying to get people to at least check out my other stuff. No one's willing to give anything but this a chance. Which really sucks for me. Like, just imagine it from my perspective for just half a second. You guys get to see what you want to see. I don't get to play what I want to play. That's like the truth. Sometimes I don't mind this game, but the moment it starts getting... How the hell do you even make this goddamn jump? The moment it gets to the hard stuff like this, I don't enjoy this. The Kaizo-esque stuff isn't fun to me. And yeah, to you guys, this probably isn't Kaizo-esque. This is probably just another romp in the park, another day with the blossoms freaking showering down on you. Whatever, however you want to say it, I don't know. Don't care. For me, this is really hard. This is like Kaizo-esque. I don't want to. How the f*** do you make this? Am I not supposed to be jumping from the top one that should be giving me more height? And yeah, go ahead and say I've made the same mistake 3 times. Well, how am I supposed to learn if it's going to work or not if I don't try it from there as far out as I possibly can, right? And I've screwed up on what I've tried to do 3 times now, so... You know, I haven't got to try it in the way that I need to try it yet. Yes, that comment before did irk me. Because I can't help it if I don't see the obvious sometimes. Part of the reason I'm not good at this. Especially when you guys make stages complicated. I don't see this makeable here. No, it is super makeable here because of course it is. Just to prove me wrong, just piss me off all the f***ing more. Boy, I look forward to having to deal with blowhards down there just blowing me all day. Roll just loves to be blown. If I can get up there and kill you fast, I will. God damn, the sooner we can get out of this, the better. I'm sorry, for me, this was miserable. This was not an enjoyable experience. I'm not good at this game. The hard stuff pisses me off. That's the way it is. That's the way it'll always be. Deal with it or leave, I guess. I don't know. I shouldn't be telling you guys to leave, but I don't like feeling like this when playing a game. I really don't like feeling like this when playing a game. Stages, leave them on my Discord, leave them on Twitter, leave them in the comments. Just know they will probably get missed in the comments. Check out these videos off to the side, I suppose. There's probably something there that I'm a little happier in than this. Sorry your stages pissed me off, Apple123N, but I can't help it. They piss me off. They're hard for me. They're hard for me because this is a game I'm not good at. They're hard for me because you saw 3/4 of my deaths. I died 3/4 of my deaths in that one goddamn spot over and over and over. How can that not frustrate me? Like, seriously. Give me something I can play? Fine. I die a lot in that. It doesn't bother me half as much. Give me something I can't play for crap and I die over and over again? It's going to piss me off. I can't help it. It does. At least it didn't depress me this time, for what that's worth. I didn't choose this, so just so you know. Either way, we're gone.